The USB Loader GX is a popular game loader for the Nintendo Wii, and its purpose is to allow playing your game backups from the USB drive. In this video, I will show you how to install it and set it up correctly. So let's get to it. You need to hack Nintendo Wii from any region. Watch my previous guide on how to do it. Then you will need a USB drive, either a USB flash drive or a USB hard drive which is formatted as FAT32. On my previous video, I used ModMe to hack the Nintendo Wii. So to synchronize from what I did on this video, I used ModMe to install the USB Loader GX. So download the latest ModMe with your preferred language from the link in the description. I downloaded the English version and I put it on the desktop. Again, I want to stress you out that if you already have the USB Loader GX on your console, you don't need to follow this section. Double-click the ModMe installer and follow the on-screen instruction. You may choose where to install ModMe, but I keep it as default, which is at the root of the C drive. Then launch ModMe. On this screen, type I agree. Since we are going to install the USB Loader GX only, then we select USB Loader Setup Plus Guide. Select FAT32. Choose USB Loader GX. Select USB. Press Next. And press Finish. Again, press Finish. The next thing is to download the USB Loader GX forwarder channel. We need to use ModMe Classic to get the job done. So now select ModMe Classic mode for more activities. Again, on this screen, type in I agree. We need to select download page 2 which includes the USB loader files, so type in number 2. I assume that you don't have the multimod manager, so we will install it together along with the USB loader forwarder channel. Type in USBX. And then type in MMM. Then press D to download the selected files. Press the Y button to begin downloading. Then you may close the app. Now select your USB drive. For my case, it is on drive H. Before continuing, we need to see the drive properties. As you can see on the screen, the file system is not FAT32. We should reformat the drive as FAT32 so that we can recognize it. Close the drive, then open the FAT32 GUI formatter. Select the USB drive letter, then press Start. Next is to copy all the downloaded files to the USB drive. Open the ModMe folder on the C drive, then open the Copy to USB folder. Drag the F folder to your USB drive. Then open the Copy to SD folder on the ModMe folder, then drag all its content to the SD card. Now plug your USB drive into the USB port nearest to the edge of the console. And don't forget to insert the SD card too. Open the Homebrew channel. If you don't have it, then please watch my previous Wii hacking video. Select Multimod Manager. Move the cursor down, then select What Manager. Select the USB Loader Forwarder channel, then press A to install it. press any button, then press the home button to go back to the homebrew channel. Press the home button, then select exit to system menu. And you will see the USB loader channel right there. The USB loader GX is capable of ripping the Wii physical game disc, so I will show you how to install the game disc into the USB drive with it. Unfortunately, I have some original Wii game disc right here. Let's run the USB loader GX. If you see this screen, then your USB drive is successfully detected by the console. If it doesn't, then please check the previous step. To dump your physical game disc, simply insert the disc into the console and it will ask you what to do with it. To install the game to your USB drive, choose Install. Then press OK to install the game. And you will see your game right there. To dump other game, simply swap the disc. And do the same thing as before. To get the game cover from the internet, move the cursor to the game box, then press OK. Then press Yes to download all the missing game covers from the internet. I think that the USB loader GX has a bug, as it is not refreshing the game database after downloading its covers, so we must click the magnifying icon to restore it. Now you see it. You can try displaying the games as grid, carousel, or channel grid. Remember that we have installed the physical game disc into the USB drive, and the game data itself is located inside the WBFS folder. The question is, how do we add or install other game format into the USB drive? For example, I got an ISO game format, a compact ISO game format, and a WBFS game format. To install the WBFS game format, we just need to copy paste the game data to the USB drive. But to install the ISO and the compact ISO, we need to use the Wii Backup Manager. The first step is to set the source game location as Drive 1. As we have the game on the desktop, we need to choose Custom Folder. And the Wii Backup Manager will detect the game on that location. Next is to assign the USB drive as Drive 2. Now we get back to Drive 1, and mark the game to be transferred to Drive 2. Then try reloading the USB loader GX. Select transfer to drive 2. Then try reloading the USB loader GX. And you will see your new games on the screen. And as usual, let's try downloading the game covers from the internet. And again, the games are not showing. You know how to solve this problem, right? And there it is. Although the Nintendo Wii is maybe outdated, I think it is still fun to hack it and play those games. The next video will be how to restore the Wii to stock firmware or remove the hack. Anyway, thanks for watching this guide and see you around.